Hello everyone, this is Dina from D's Fine Art, and today I'm going to start on an abstract oil painting. So I should put away my water because that's for acrylics and bring out my mineral spirits. I have four jars that all look the same, so it's sort of difficult to tell sometimes which one's which. Yep, found it. There we go. So I use a glass palette, but I put it in, let me see if I can move this for a second. This like container, which I bought on Amazon, and that's pretty easy to use. I just scrape it off after I'm done like this. The glass on this, the one here is, unfortunately I got some of my acrylic pouring art on it, like paint, and that paint is like almost impossible to get off. So that's why I'm having to use this piece of glass instead. Right. It's almost melting. Alright, so I've got my oil paints down here in this. They're mostly Daniel Smith paints, which are my favorites. Let me pick out some colors. Let's see. And I'm going to take out my liquin olio pasto and my liquin impasto, because I want this one to have like thick texture. It already has on it some acrylic medium that makes this like sandy, grainy texture, which I quite like. So I will be using that too. Right. I've had these paints for years and years. I still like them. And sometimes it's a struggle to get paint out, but that's okay. Ooh, I want to try this unbleached titanium white that I bought recently, but I never used. Maybe some yellow ochre. Okay, I think that's enough for now. Move this a little so you can, whoops, see what I'm doing first. This is my phthalo blue. Chunk of white. I'll probably need more white than that, but I'll wait. I'm not sure I'll need this Hansa yellow, so I'm not going to use it yet. Here's some burnt umber. Actually, I'm going to stick with the liquin olio pasto this time. So I'm going to put just a little bit of that out Oh, it's dried up because I haven't used it in forever. Well, that isn't much. Keep the ones I think I may need again over here. I want to try some Van Dyke Brown. I haven't really used this color much, but it looks so rich and beautiful, so I want to try it. Not sure I'm going to need this either, but I'm going to put a tiny bit. Well, actually, that's not really a tiny bit. For impasto style, that is pretty tiny. Generally, oil paintings don't require that much paint, but if you're doing sort of abstract work that's not about blending and that's more about you know, texture, then you need a lot of paint. Okay, so this is my palette, my starting palette, and now I'm going to switch the camera back. Man, that light is really strong. Okay, a little better. So these are the brushes I just used in my acrylic painting. So I think I'm probably not, well, I'll try not to use them. Although I personally like to reuse my brushes so that I don't have to wash as many at the end. If I'm going to use them, I'll just run them through the mineral spirits a little. Okay. So when I start an abstract painting, I don't usually have like a specific thing I want to do. It's really about the colors and sort of putting the brush on the canvas and then deciding how I feel and what I want to express. So I know that sounds like hippy-dippy, but we'll see how it goes. This is a Princeton Art filbert, which I'm going to start with. It's pretty big, but that works well for such a large canvas. Alright, so I'm taking some of my liquin olio pasto, mixing it with my phthalo blue, because that is the color I always love to start with. Wow, I really like this texture. trying to get some coverage on the canvas right now. Doesn't matter too much where I'm going to put what color. So what the Liquin Olio Pasto does is it maintains some of the brush strokes, and it also, it's a fast drying medium, so it makes the painting dry faster, which is great for oils, because then that means I can work on this painting tomorrow if I don't finish it today. Whereas if I were using just regular oil paints and making it thick, then you know it's going to take weeks to dry enough to do it another layer. Alright, so I'm out of the blue, so instead of continuing with blue, I'm going to switch it up and go with some of this unbleached titanium white, which will mix in with the blue, because I'm reusing the same spot. Give a sort of greenish color, which is, I guess, to be expected. I really should adjust this so it's not so wobbly. These Princeton brushes are good brushes, so they can withstand some abuse, which is nice, because I like to scrub in the paint sometimes. Let's switch to something a little darker. This is the burnt umber. And the fact that the brush has blue on it means that burnt umber will be a little duller than usual, probably. Intentionally getting these darker spots that sort of hang off the edges of this acrylic paint. I need a little bit of thinner here. The thinner helps me get a little more coverage quickly. Because otherwise the dry paint is just, it's sort of hard to move around. So. some white and the rest of the burnt umber and some olio pasto and mix them in together. To me, the coolest thing about abstract art is that you just let go and see where it takes you. So you don't have to have a plan or anything. You just pick up a brush and see what happens. Of course, it's fine if you plan too. Like sometimes I'll have an idea and then I'll just execute that idea. But you can also make stuff without planning ahead when the mood hits. Titanium white. It helped to get some of the browns on the brush to even out the blue a bit so that I could actually get some of this unbleached titanium white color. Sort of like this pink showing through actually, so I may actually try to make that color with the red that I have or something similar. Created a little bit of a pinkish tone. Try to blend in. So some Van Dyke brown mixed with some of this older whitish colors, pinkish stuff. So it should be sort of not really a pure Van Dyke brown. And it's not thick enough, so I need to add some more paint. Trying to tame this blue color here a bit with some of the browns. Brown tends to dull the blue colors a bit, make it not quite so bright. Out of the olio pasto, need some more. My yellow ochre. Really like this area, so I'm gonna not mess with it. I added some white to this yellow ochre because I discovered I really didn't like that color on the canvas. Do something pretty drastic right now. Well, it didn't turn out too drastic once I mixed it with the previous paint. It's black, but it turns out sort of gray now that I've mixed it with a little bit of whatever was left on the palette, which is like this whitish brown. I'm really liking all of these colors, but I think the blue isn't working very well. Okay, I think that means I'm going to need a whole lot of browns. This is raw umber, but it's very hard to squeeze out of this tube, so I'm going to ignore that one. Actually, I should throw this tube away. And I can't open the other tube. All right, burnt sienna. That should be doable. It's a little brighter than I'd like for this painting, so I will have to dull it down with some blue, which is fine because I always squeeze out too much blue. All right, some white, some olio pasto, and then I'll take the burnt sienna. Let's see if we can get some coverage of this blue. Actually, the blue might be easier to cover with a knife, so I'm gonna do that. Besides, I love painting with a knife, so. It might be a challenge actually because of the green though. don't mind having the blue really subtle coming in, but I just didn't want it to be this bright. Looking much better. I'm definitely feeling like this is not the correct orientation for this painting. Actually, this might be better. I'm trying to make it so that the knife effects, like usually if you put a knife down and go like this, it leaves this specific effect, which I love, but I'm trying to make this not look like a necessarily knife painting. So that's not the effect I'm going for here. This light, this side seems sort of light compared to all this. So I think I'm going to try to add a little texture here. It's trickier when it's smooth to make it not look like a knife. Let's see. I think I'm gonna leave it like this for now and then do another layer tomorrow. Thanks for watching.